Welcome to our celebration this morning. I'm Reverend Myra Brown, and I'd like to extend a warm welcome to any visitors we have with us this morning. If you're visiting with us for the first time, we invite you to please stand. We want to welcome you. Amen. Amen. You may be seated. We want you to know that we're absolutely thrilled that you've decided to join us this morning, and we know you're going to have a great time in the Lord. Amen. I have a few announcements. A reminder that our Speaking from the Heart ministry is meeting today at 11:30 over in the dining room of Celebration Hall on the second floor. It's our wonderful ministry in helping refugees and immigrants learn the English language, connect with them, build relationships. So if you're interested in being part of that beautiful ministry, know that you are welcome to join us today at 11:30. Also, our buddy readers are looking for more readers for children. So if you're interested in that, every Monday morning, they read to children grades kindergarten to second grade at World of Inquiry School number 58. And so if you feel called to that, you can email Marcy DeJesus, and her information is listed in the bulletin this week. So give her a call. Also, a reminder that this coming Tuesday is my last Tuesday morning tennis, and if you'd like to play tennis with me, I'd love to play with you at Cobbs Hill on Tuesday morning at 10 o'clock, so give me a call in the office and meet me there, and let's connect more together and learn more about each other. And also, this coming Tuesday is our part two of the summer Bible study series, Healing the Wounds. So if there's a part of your life that needs healing, join us as we walk through the scriptures together towards more healing for our lives. And that's this coming Tuesday from 5:30 to 7. Please stand and join us for our opening song on page 11, City of God. Beautiful. Before we begin, let's say hello to the people around you or introduce yourself to somebody you don't know. Let us begin. Reverend Mary is away on vacation, so we'll continue to keep her in our prayers that she has a wonderful rested vacation. Let us begin. In the name of our loving God, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Thank you. Just invite you to relax, drop your shoulders, let go of any worries you have. Know that you're in the right place at the right time. God is right here with you. Just feel God's Spirit surrounding you. And if you need anything from God, this is a beautiful time to just ask for that and let God give you what you need. May our loving God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and lead us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. God, thank you so much for waking us up this morning. Thank you for this beautiful day, this time to praise you, to worship you. We ask you to give us what we need this week that we might follow you more closely to make our world a better place. We pray through Christ our Lord. You may be seated. Every August, we get to celebrate our Grace of God Recovery House ministry. It was one of the first outreaches that we started at Spritus Christi. We began in 1999, working with men in recovery. Sister Margie is our founder and director of that ministry. And so we just welcome her this morning, as she is our preacher this morning, to help us celebrate all the amazing work that happens there. So help me show Sister Margie some love. Our readers this morning are Jim and Sue, and our signer is Catherine.
Good morning. A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. As I watched, thrones were set up, and the Ancient One took his throne. His clothing was bright as snow, and the hair on his head as white as wool. His throne was flames of fire with wheels of burning fire. A surging stream of fire flowed out from where he sat. Thousands upon thousands were ministering to him, and myriads upon myriads attended him. The court was convened, and the books were opened. As the visions during the night continued, I saw one like a son of man coming on the clouds of heaven. When he reached the Ancient One and was presented before him, the one like a son of humanity received dominion, glory, and kingship. All peoples, nations, and languages serve him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that shall not be taken away. His kingship shall not be destroyed. The word of the Lord.
And again, good morning. The responsorial psalm, the response is, the Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. The Lord is King, let the earth rejoice. Let the many islands be glad. Clouds and darkness are around about him. Justice and judgment use the foundation of his throne. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. The mountains melt away like wax before the Lord. Before the Lord, all the earth, the heavens proclaim his justice, and the peoples see his glory. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. Because you, O Lord, are the Most High over all the earth, exalt far above all the gods. The Lord is King, the Most High over all the earth. The second reading is a reading from the second letter of St. Peter. Beloved, we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. But we had been eyewitnesses of his majesty, for he received honor and glory from God the Father when that unique declaration came to him from the majestic glory. This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice come from the heavens while we were with him on the holy mountain. Moreover, we possess the prophetic message that is altogether reliable. You will do well to be attentive to it, as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. The word of our Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus took Peter, James, and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, conversing with him. Then Peter said to Jesus in reply, Lord, it is good that we are here. If you wish, I will make three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them. Then from the cloud, a voice that said, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. When the disciples heard this, they fell prostrate and were very much afraid. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, Get up and do not be afraid. And when the disciples raised their eyes, they saw no one else but Jesus alone. As they were coming down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, Do not tell the vision to anyone until the Son of Humanity has been raised from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord. About 7 years ago, we had a resident at Grace of God Recovery House who wasn't very happy with all the rules. But he didn't have any other safe place to go, and he really did want to recover. So he decided he would stay and dig in. Well, his stay lasted longer than it usually did. And finally, he gradually fell in love with the Grace of God community, rules and all. Finally, after 8 months, a bed opened for him in a halfway house, and it was time for him to leave. I told him to pack up his things and that I would take him at 10 o'clock the next morning. Well, 10 o'clock came and no sign of him. So I went upstairs, I called his name, no response. I looked in the bedroom, the bathroom, I looked outside, I looked everywhere. He was nowhere to be found. So I took one more look up in his room. There on his bed were all his things packed up neatly, but he was nowhere to be found. Next, I was about ready to leave when I looked down and saw the tips of 2 feet sticking out from under the bed. I said to him, "Come out from under there. What are you doing?" He said, "I thought if I hid under here, I wouldn't have to leave." Yeah. It was home for him. He had found Grace of God to be a very special place. Today, he is on the staff of Grace of God. He has a full-time job in his own apartment. Similarly, in today's gospel story of Jesus' transfiguration, Peter, James, and John found themselves in a very special place. Suddenly, Jesus' appearance changed, and they experienced him like they had never experienced him before. It was powerful and overwhelming, and they wanted it to last forever. Just like the resident at Grace of God hiding under the bed, they didn't want to leave. They just wanted to stay there. Then when Moses and Elijah appeared with Jesus, Peter got so excited that he wanted to set up 3 tents so they could just stay there. "Lord," he said, "if you wish, I will set up 3 tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." Well, while he was saying this, a bright cloud cast a shadow over them, and God interrupted Peter. Imagine talking and then being interrupted by God. Well, that happens a lot at the Grace of God. God interrupts the negative thoughts that residents carry about themselves and reminds them that they are loved and precious. These interruptions of God come from many different places, perhaps from a therapist or a sponsor or a homily at church, or sometimes it comes from a family member or even in a dream. God has so many ways of communicating with us. Father Jim tells a story of his grandfather who struggled with alcoholism and always hung out with the kids at family gatherings. He wasn't so popular with the adults, but he said he liked being with the kids because the kids always think you're a hell of a fella. Well, that's how God sees the men at Grace of God Recovery House. There's no judgment. God thinks that each and every one of them is a hell of a fella. So God interrupts Peter now, and here's what he says. "This is my beloved son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." While being overwhelmed, the disciples fell down in fear. But Jesus came and touched them, and he told them what he tells us over and over and over again: "Get up and do not be afraid." The disciples gradually looked up, and they saw that once again they were alone with Jesus. For me, the most important part of this event is the voice of God saying, "This is my beloved son with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." Notice that God didn't say, "This is my beloved son, worship him." He didn't say, "Adore him or glorify him." God didn't say, "Praise Jesus." God said, "Listen to him." The definition of listen is twofold. It means to take notice and to act. on what someone says. Listening is more than just hearing. We can hear the words of Jesus all day long, but never really listen to them. Listening takes an action, and it is a huge part of what the men do at Grace of God Recovery House. Taking suggestions is core to the process of recovery. Listening to God's voice that comes from their sober support, or the words of the AA or NA or SA books, or the messages that they hear at meetings, and the suggestions from the Grace of God community, all provide a foundation for changing their behaviors. And we know that recovery is all about changing behaviors. It's not so much about the alcohol or the drugs. It's about being transfigured, about being transformed. It's about changes and surrender. Sometimes at Grace of God, there are residents who don't complete the program. They either leave early, or sometimes we have to ask them to leave. This is really difficult, but we are comforted in knowing that God can do what we can't, and that we never really know how well they have been listening. One man, Mike, wanted to do the program his way, but it wasn't working. He continued to have one conflict after another with the program, so we had to ask him to leave. He was young, and he thought he could do it his way. After he left, reality hit. Things began to fall apart pretty quickly. But in his head, he could still hear the suggestions of the people that he left behind. Slowly, he began to put these suggestions into practice. He reconnected with God and church, and he said that acting on those suggestions saved his life. A few months ago, Mike came down the aisle at the 7:30 Mass, and he placed his newborn baby girl right next to me on my seat. We both hugged as tears streamed down his face. "Isn't he beautiful, sister?" And without Grace of God, this baby never would have been possible. We live in a very troubled world where who we listen to makes all the difference. There are so many voices out there, but Jesus has a lot to say to us about healing our troubled world. Here's what he says. Share your bread with the hungry. Forgive 70 times 7. Welcome the stranger. Give to anyone who asks. Love your enemies. Don't be anxious for your life, what you're going to wear, what you're going to eat, what you're going to drink. And do not judge. Be at peace with one another. Take care of your parents when they are old. Lend and expect nothing in return. And do not be afraid. There are some other things that Jesus said that are even more difficult. Here's one. Enter by the narrow gate, for the gate is wide that leads to destruction. But the gate is small and the road is narrow that leads to life. This quote from Jesus speaks a language that people in recovery really understand. For them, the wide gate leads to the road of addiction, a road that is paved with lies and pain, misery, despair, and hopelessness. But that road is wide, and lots of people choose it. The narrow gate, on the other hand, leads to the road of recovery. That road is paved with hard work, rigorous honesty, service work, prayer and meditation, sober support, and the 12-step programs. Ultimately, this narrow road leads to a life of peace, joy, and serenity for those who choose it. Grace of God Recovery House was founded in 1999 by the generous and loving people of Spritus Christi Church. For the last 18 years, this community has served and supported hundreds of men who have chosen the narrow gate of recovery. The staff and volunteers are extraordinary servants who make the whole ministry run smoothly. The diseases of alcoholism and addiction have taken the lives of so many beautiful people, many of them very young. And presently, the heroin epidemic is breaking the hearts of families and loved ones at an alarming rate. Please keep those in active addiction and their families in your prayers. And parents, be informed and engage your children in conversation and education about alcoholism and drug addiction. Remember that these are family diseases, and your children have a right to know about their family history and the dangers of experimenting. And kids, especially you teens, be honest with your parents and talk to them about your fears and your questions. They love you, and we love you, and we are here for you. Don't be afraid to get help if you need it. On behalf of the entire Grace of God community, thank you, Spritus Christi. You have listened to the words of Jesus, and you have acted on them. Lives have been saved, hearts have been filled with peace and joy, and God is very, very, very well pleased with each and every one of you. God bless.
Your time waiting for that second chance and a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful release. Let memories seep from my veins. Let me be empty, how and weightless, and maybe I'll find some peace tonight in the arms of the angel. Straight line, and everywhere you turn, there's vultures and thieves at your back. Storm keeps on twisting, keep on building lies that you make up for all that you lack. It don't make no difference. Oh, escaping one more time. It's easier You're in the arms of the angel. May you find some comfort here.
That was Mary Stacy Reinhardt. Beautiful. Thank you so much. Now it's time for our offertory collection. We have an opportunity to keep this beautiful ministry going. So there are special envelopes for Grace of God Recovery House that you can add to the regular collection. So if you need those, the ushers have them. You just signal them and they'll get those to you. And thank you in advance for your generosity to keep this beautiful ministry going. And while we do that, we will sing another song on page 13, Day by Day.
Oh, dear Lord, please inside pray. thought I was done. Today, along with the gifts of bread and wine, we have brought to the altar four books that play an important part of the life of recovery for the men at Grace of God. That is the AA Big Book, the NA Basic Text, the White Book of Sexaholics Anonymous, and the Bible. We also place on the altar the names of the different agencies from our community that we network with during our time. And it takes a village to raise a child, we all know that, and it takes a whole community to walk with people in recovery. So these are the agencies that we network with. Unity Inpatient at Park Ridge Hospital, Evelyn Brandon Addictions and Mental Health Services, Norris Clinic, Restart, Catholic Family Services, Monroe County Jail, East House Corporation, Pathways of Rochester, Al-Anon, Nar-Anon, and ACOA, Spritus Christi Prison Ministry, The Catholic Worker, Alcoholics Anonymous, Narcotics Anonymous, Sexaholics Anonymous, St. Joseph's Neighborhood Center, Huther Doyle Addiction Services, Rochester Police Department, Spritus Christi Mental Health Center, Syracuse Behavioral Health, Rochester Mental Health Services, Strong Addictions, Monroe County Probation, New York State Parole, Monroe County Drug Court, Matthew's Closet, Rochester Works, Monroe County Department of Human Services, VESID, Voters Block Community, and Spritus Christi Church.
Let's also pray for Reverend Myra. It's her birthday today. Let's pray for everybody in the hospital, people struggling with mental illness, depression, anxiety, people in active addiction. And who's on your mind today that you would like to pray for? You could just mention their names out loud. And now let's give our hearts to God. Everybody's in a different place this morning. Whatever mood you're in, whatever's making you happy, whatever's causing you pain, whatever you're worried about, just give it to God. Blessed are you, loving God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread and wine to offer, which the earth has given, human hands put together. They will become our spiritual food and drink. Blessed be God forever. May God be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks to our loving God. We want to thank you today, God, for this beautiful ministry. We want to thank you for all the people that are part of the healing. But we know the main person is you. You're the main healer. And so we praise you and honor you with the saints in heaven as we sing this prayer. Dear God, you are so beautiful. You're so holy. Let us feel your holiness right now as you consecrate us to you, along with these gifts of bread and wine that come from this beautiful planet. And we all become the living body of Christ. Before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took the bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me. Now we proclaim the mystery of our faith. Thank you, God, for bringing us together today from so many different places. We come from different religions, different backgrounds, but you love us all the same, no matter what. Thanks for sending Jesus here to show us the love of God. We know that he treated everybody with kindness and compassion, no matter who they were. He didn't care what group they belonged to, what language they spoke. He healed people and loved people and forgave people whenever they came to him. He forgave all the people before he died. And then he rose from the dead, and he gave us life that goes on forever. So we can only say thank you again, God. That's why we're here, to say thank you. We give you this life-giving bread, this saving cup, in memory of those acts of love. And God, thanks for this moment right now, just being able to stand in your presence with all these beautiful people in this holy place one more time. We pray for our churches, pray for Pope Francis and all spiritual leaders, pray for Jews, Muslims, Hindus, Buddhists. May we all work together and heal our world. And God, bless those who have died, especially those in the Grace of God community who have died, Johnny Milton, Tom Heaton, Mark Travis, Herb Lateau, Juan Clark, James Hill, Rick Regulus, Clint Rogers, Shane Russell, and all the people we miss. And God, one day when we die, save us a place, along with Mary and Joseph and the prophets and all the people who have done your will. We will praise you in union with them. We will give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. For it is through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty God, forever and ever. God's peace be with you. Thank you very much. Let's offer that peace to each other. Friends, behold the Lamb of God who comes to us under these humble disguises. He's the one who loves us. He wants to feed us today. He wants to take care of us, give us what we need for the week. What a great privilege to be called to this table. Lord, you make me worthy to receive you. By your word, I am healed. This is a great moment. Communion. Everybody's welcome to the table. Nobody's left out. We all need the Lord. We need God's help and strength and energy to get through this week and to make the world better. So please come up and take this portion of love that God has for you. And then you can either dip in the blue cup, which has grape juice, or drink from the wine, whichever is better for you. If you need a gluten-free host, they're available at this station here and the one in the balcony. Everybody's welcome.
Through the dark. Good morning, I'm Tom Wright, and did anybody pick up the golf story in today's gospel?
No.
There were four guys, Jesus, Peter, John, and James, on the mountain, perfect foursome. And what Matthew didn't tell us is on the way down the Mount of Transfiguration, as they probably stopped at the Mount of Transfiguration Golf and Chariot Club for a quick round of golf. It's August. It's a fundraising month for Grace of God Recovery House. And there's one great way you can support us, many great ways to support us, but one of them is you could come and play golf with us and have dinner at our 17th annual golf and barbecue dinner. It's September 10th. It's a Sunday afternoon. It's at Shadow Lake Golf Course in Penfield. There's many ways you can participate. You can play and eat with us. You can sponsor a hole. You can sponsor Sister Margie's cart, or you could just come to dinner. We also have a need for volunteers. We're going to also have a silent auction that night at the dinner. If you can put a foursome together to play, that'd be great. If you can't put a foursome together, we'll be able to match you up, and we'll take any level of golfers. You don't have to be a great golfer. We'll have flyers in the back of the church. If you have any questions, my phone number's on the flyer, plus all the details about how to sponsor this program. And I'm going to turn it over to Todd.
Good morning. My name is Todd Shermer, and I'm here to talk to you about another way that you can support Grace of God. Now, if you're like me, and I'm, in my career I'm a banker, I'm probably the only banker in this country that doesn't golf. So there are some other things you can do if you don't golf. And we ask you to host an event. And what we mean by host an event, it could be a dinner. My husband and I do a big dinner, and we invite friends, we invite family, we invite parishioners here at church, and we put on a dinner and we ask everybody to bring a donation to Grace of God. Reverend Myra on her birthday is having a birthday party today, and she is asking her friends and family to bring a donation for Grace of God instead of a gift. So there's many options. Maybe you have a pool, you want to do a pool party. Watch the weather if you do that this year, for sure. Or maybe you want to have just dessert and coffee, or a brunch, or a volleyball game in your backyard. There's many ways you can just have an event and ask everybody to bring a donation to Grace of God. My name and phone number is in the bulletin if you have any questions, or I'll be at the exit over here today if you you want to ask me anything about how to host an event or how it works. Thank you.
Hi, I'm the third ring of the three-ring circus. Just like to tell you about one more event that we're having this year. Sometimes people ask us, what can I do for Grace of God? What can I do for the men? And here is something you can do. Each time a man comes to the house for the first time, they receive a person who is their primary staff person who does an orientation with them. At the orientation, they receive a key to the house, and along with that, they receive money for a haircut and a bus pass. Now, the money for the haircut is really important because you know how you feel when your hair's not right and you get a haircut and you just feel so much better. So they get a haircut, and that's the beginning of rebuilding their self-esteem. They feel better about themselves, they look better. The other thing is that haircut is a symbol of their cut on the life of addiction. And so getting that haircut gives them a fresh start. Also, they get a bus pass, which is their transportation to all of their AA and NA meetings and their other appointments and groups. So, if you would like to be part of a man's fresh start, you can make a donation of $30 on your way out today, and that will go towards somebody's fresh start. If you make that donation, you will receive a bracelet like this that says, "One Day at a Time." And that way you will be able to remember to pray for the men at Grace of God. And also, as you look at your bracelet, you can remember that we all need to slow down, to take life more mindfully and more easily, and to remember all the graces that God has given us. So do it one day at a time, and do it today. Thank you.
Happy birthday to you. Happy
you guys so much. I think y'all just like to make me cry. Let us pray. Thank you, God, for this time together with you. Thank you for beautiful music, for a great message. Thank you for this beautiful ministry and Sister Margie's leadership and all the amazing volunteers and all the residents that have come through this house. We ask you to send us forth today to continue to listen to Jesus' words of life as we continue to recover the parts of our lives that need recovering and work with you to transform our world. We pray through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Thank you. May our God bless us in the name of our loving God, Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our celebration is ended. Let's go in love and peace to serve our God. Our closing song is on page 21, Go Tell It on the Mountain.